If you recall, this is the basic equation for a pressure field when there are no shear stresses. So it's actually the general equation of motion because we have both pressure and body force. So what happens if there's a fluid at rest? So for a fluid at rest, A, or acceleration, equals zero. So this reduces to del P plus specific weight in the K direction equals zero. Because the right side is zero, we can multiply everything by negative one, end up with positive. So if we put this in our component form, dP dx has to equal zero because there's no I component. dP dy has to equal zero because there's no J component. And dP dz equals negative the specific weight. And the pressure, therefore, does not depend on X or Y. So we can rewrite this whole thing as dP dz equals minus our specific weight. In other words, this is now an ordinary differential equation. We can use this then to find what's called the hydrostatic distribution. In other words, what a pressure is at a certain point. And what we do is we separate and integrate this. So we go from some P1 to P2 dP equals minus the specific weight, which is a constant, Z1 to Z2 dz. And this ends up being that P2 minus P1 equals our specific weight, Z2 minus Z1, or we can write this as P1 minus P2 equals, getting rid of the negative sign, Z2 minus Z1. We let Z2 minus Z1 equal the height between the two. And now we can write this as P1 minus P2 equals this specific volume times the height. And we can use this equation for a number of different situations, including the manometer equation, as well as hydrostatic forces on a submerged surface.